Welcome to the City Current Show. I'm your host, Jeremy Park. Our mission at City Current is to power the good, and we do that through positive media, events, and philanthropy. This show features interviews with a mix of business and community leaders who discuss important efforts, trends, lessons learned, and ways to get involved so we can learn more about our community and work together to make a difference. Now, on to the show.
Welcome to the City Current Show. I'm Andrew Bartolotta. Today we're discussing a body renewed, a spirit reborn, and a home revived with the founder of Annestasis and the Annestation, Stacey Johnson. Stacey, thanks for joining us today.
Oh, Andrew, it's so great to be with you. It's such a fun day to be able to connect on this radio show with you. So it's great.
I'm so excited to talk more about Annestasis. First, give listeners a quick history for your career and background, which includes health and wellness, painting, and more.
Okay, wonderful. My background is that I have reinvented myself over and over again. So shockingly, all of the different careers, so stockbroker and assistant for an interior designer and a stay-at-home mom, and that culmination of what seemed like a patchwork quilt of careers actually serves me very well right now doing the work that I'm doing, which is wonderful. I do have a background in interior decor. I don't like to say interior design because that's a completely different game and it involves blueprints. What I like to focus in on is healthy home living. And so for me as a person and me as a professional, I like for people's houses to work smartly. And that does involve some organization, but it also, it involves listening and having a conversation about what fits a family best. You know, people, now that we've been home with, the pandemic, people are really rethinking their spaces. I mean, they're getting creative with closets and where the broom used to be. And, you know, do we really need that kitchen so much? So for me, I'm going into people's homes and as an extension of their getting healthy and creating a new life, they want their surroundings to be healthy as well. So I bring that interior decor in there. I'm also just a holistic coach. So if someone comes to me and wants a healthier body and a healthy diet and a healthy exercise program, we can definitely do that. And I have done that in my personal life. Certainly have done that and I'm glad to do it. But what I find, Andrew, is the conversation is always about more than that. If it were just about the food and the exercise, we'd all be in our prime health. We'd all be there. I mean, because it would be a no-brainer. But the truth is that sometimes it involves lack of self-care. It involves, it involves lack of time, lack of resources. So I'm able to actually even pull from the being a financial consultant back in the early 90s into that conversation. I have certainly been a single mom before and know all about that demographic. And that is a tough spot to be in. I really appreciate it. So keeping in mind physical health, financial health, moving into a spiritual place, which I think I think that's the origin of all of it. Natural transfer from that, or what is a natural process from that place is that you want your surroundings to also be healthy. So my background is art and interior design and financial, and I've been in the business and now I'm an entrepreneur, and they all play into this life that I'm living today, which is about as good as it gets. I'm very excited about being a 53-year-old. And what I tell people is that I'll start lying about my age when my life starts getting worse, but every year has been better and better. So I'm not there yet.
I love the way that you live your life and help others, and talk about your mission and services at Annestasis, which includes what I love this term. You say how resurrection looks in our daily lives.
As a Christian, that's my religious background. I have always heard about resurrection as what Christ did. We celebrated Easter. It's a one and done. It was amazing. It's a hallelujah. We all get excited about it. And then I've done some introspection. The name Stacey is actually derived from Annestasis, which means to be born again. And as I started to really dive into that, I realized, oh my gosh, that was modeled for us because we have to do it hundreds of times in our lifetime. In order to get from one season to the next, Andrew, we really do have to put behind the things that were, you know, we were originally holding on to so that we can reach something else. Some examples are, you know, when you're doing the, you know, the monkey bars where you've got the holes, if you don't let go of this, you can't grab that. I mean, it's as simple as that. But also nature is such a great example of it. And I just kind of take my cues from nature. There is, especially in the Mid-South area, there's a seasonal dying off. My favorite season of all is fall. And that means trees are dying, literally. And they will go into, literally, I'm just watching trees pass away right in front of me. And they'll go into a space in the winter where it looks like they're never going to come back. Mm-hmm. And then the spring happens. That's just a perfect example of what we do. So, for instance, in my world, three young children going through a divorce, very difficult time, trying to figure out how to make it all happen. I had two choices. One, I could stay in the bitter space. I could just talk and rehash and discuss until ad nauseum about all the things that went wrong and how right I am. That was option number one. Option number two was I could use it as a growing space. And I turned the mirror back toward myself and I figured out what are the things that I need to let go of, or otherwise this situation is going to repeat itself over and over again, over and over again. So there were things that I needed to die to, habits, addictions. I had to lean into health and well-being. I do recovery, which is a big yay, but I had to do some things to be reborn again. And yes, it required me to let some things stay in that rearview mirror in order for me to kind of be a whole person. Professionally, I promise you, it has been that way professionally. The reason Annestasis was born was because of just not able to find that perfect management job that I thought would be laid in my lap when I graduated from college. It just never happened. And I thought, well, I think I'll invent something for myself. I hope that answers your question.
It does. And I love that you're not afraid to try new things. You know, we talk a lot and you'll say, you know, I'm speaking this into existence, and like, boom, there you go. And it's cool. And you're not afraid to try new things. And I think with the resurrection of your being and the multitude of different Stacys and your lifespan, you know that there's an opportunity to grow in your space and who you are. And when you were talking about nature, there's our tree in our front yard every year in the fall, in the wintertime, I tell my wife, this is the year, it's not coming back. Look, it looks dead, it's not coming back. And by March, she looks at me and she's like, I told you so, it's coming back. And when you think about that in your life and as a Christian as well, just being reborn, it really is just this sense that you have the opportunity to try new things because you're able to, and you're not limited to just one season in your life. So when we talk about nature, you recently held an art reception for your work, Nature Amplified. Talk about that work and your unique process of creating art, which includes inspiration for music as well.
Oh, thank you. Yes. So I love art and I like, I'm always inspired by different things. I've had different shows and they've had a different flavor. This one was really cool, Andrew, because Natalie Montgomery at the Levitt Shell asked me to do a book study for the Levitt Shell. They have a wonderful health and wellness series. Baptist sponsors it. It's a great idea. She said she wanted to do a book study as it pertained to art. And I was thinking, and she'd like it to be about nature. So I quickly did some research and happened upon a book called The Nature Fix. Now, if I'm confessing and being honest, I thought it was going to be just a check mark. I thought it would be fine and I would read this book. But what I found is there's so much scientific evidence about how healing nature literally is. And I mean, in prisons, in schools, they're really, really diving in and researching, looking at the data about how much better we feel when the tree is in our front yard versus when we're in a concrete jungle. That being said, I started taking, knowing that this show was coming up, I started taking pictures of different things that caught my eye, frog, dragonfly, that caught my eye in nature. And I wanted to put that in a fun, lively, colorful place with those colors. And I love mixed media and I like a real textured piece of art. So anyway, I allowed it to do that. So, you know, the frog in my collection is bright red because it can be, and that's the beauty of painting. I like to do an impressionistic style of painting. It's fun for me and I enjoy it. And you mentioned music. Most of the time what I do is, and I didn't even know I was doing it until I became a little bit more aware of what I was doing. I would paint in silence and I realized there was a song going in a loop in my head. The first one I noticed was a piece that I painted for myself, and I could hear that police song Synchronicity over and over and over in my head. And I was like, oh my gosh, I do that every time, don't I? So I started compiling a list of music. Usually it's got a great beat, and I found a genre that I love. Who has ever heard of acid jazz? I had no idea. It is like a little rap and a little jazz, and it's spot on because it's got to be about the rhythm. So when I create art, it's almost as if I'm a conductor of an orchestra, literally. That brush is doing that to the beat of the music. So it does need some backbeat. It does need some backbeat. And the colors are my muse. But I had a great time capturing that collection. It was just a lot of fun. And so I enjoyed it thoroughly.
Quickly talk about your team at Annestasis, because I mean, you know, you were talking about the home decor, spiritual reborn, but you also have, you know, Maggie and Jana. Talk about what they do and how sort of their services offered.
We like to consider ourselves at Annestasis as almost a virtual health and wellness salon. I mean, and everybody's got their niche. And I love having the partnership with Jana and Maggie, and we're actually seeking more partners that have a little bit of a niche that can come on board. But specifically, Maggie is an incredible, her art is food, and she's an incredible chef. And I knew that Maggie was leaning in a very healthy food process. I knew she was just because she's a friend of mine. I called her up and said, would you be interested? What do you think? So Maggie brought her expertise, and she creates to-go healthy meals. So it's a pickup casserole. It's a this or it's that, but it's also very measured out as far as ingredients are concerned. It's got all the macros in there. And what I love about Maggie is, if that wasn't good enough, and it should be, Maggie's a woman of prayer. So she prays over the food. To her, it's a ministry. She prays for her customers. It's without being too, you know, churchy, it's a big deal for her to be able to nourish people. And that's what she calls her business, nourishing. She wants to nourish people's bodies, but she also wants to, again, dive into that self-care realm where people are taking good care of themselves because they're eating properly. She has been at home before, and she'll tell you when you talk to her, and eating olives and cheese out of the refrigerator, because that's all that was. It was on plan, but it was like she had no self-respect at that point, and she wants to keep people from going to that space. And that's Maggie, and she is light and love and all things yummy about food. So yay, Maggie. Jana Cardona, just a beautiful soul, has decided to pull back and reinvent herself. So she is in the middle of an Annestasis right here, right now, formerly owner of two BNI businesses. And she decided to pull back from that on a full-time basis and do the Gallup Strengths Finder evaluation. She's done mine, so I can speak as a happy, happy customer. What she wants to do is to help people stand in their strongest assets. So instead of focusing in on the things you wish were different, I wish I was lighter, healthier, wealthier, better. What Jana wants to do is draw people back to what their God-given strengths are and let them stand in that. So she wants to spotlight them, discuss them, and also teach people how to utilize them in their life professionally, personally, with their family, So Jana is bringing that to the table, and it's lovely.
Stacey, thank you so much for coming on the show today.
My pleasure, my friend. Good to see you.
Welcome to the City Current Show. I'm your host, Andrew Bartolotta. Today, we're diving into managing a household and getting your home from chaos to calm with personal organizer, BarbieJo Hatch. BarbieJo, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, so you're a mother of five and a farmer's wife. How did you get started as a professional organizer?
So actually, it was because I'm a farmer's wife. We had two failed crops in a row. And back to back, that's a hard financial thing to recover from. So I found myself standing in line at a government office waiting to apply for assistance. And I was like, you know what? I have got to do something to help my family. What could that be? And I was reflecting back on the skills I had, on the education I had, and all the training I had. I tried a few multi-level marketing companies. Nothing really felt right until I met a business coach, and she said, what could you see yourself doing for the next 10 years? And we were in the middle of another move, and I loved it. I thrive in that environment, just being organized, having everything where it needs to be. And I just love that. So I said, organizing, I love to organize. She said, bingo, there you go. So I took it from that day forward and built on that, on this skill that I've been using my entire life. I built a business around it, launched a podcast, created a community of moms. And now I'm writing a regular contributor for City Magazine here in Texas.
Very cool. So this might be a little bit of a loaded question, but for someone that is working from home while raising babies, how do you manage that?
Okay, so when the world shut down, right, and we all were stuck at home for so long and everything turned virtual, we had to get crafty. We were turning our dining room tables into schoolrooms. We were turning our closets into offices, our bedrooms into offices. We had to get really crafty and creative. And even today, some of that has stuck. And we are doing quite a bit virtually still, which is quite convenient, I will say. But there was a bit of balancing. When you're managing being a mom, being a business owner, managing a household, managing a business, you have to have balance. And my best tips for that is to have set business hours and to have a set business zone in your home that you can close off, and it's free from distraction. You're not going to be distracted by, you know, the things of everyday life, that you can kind of close out the world and focus in on work. But then your family also understands that these are working hours from, you know, this time to this time. And anything outside of that is fair game, family time. That's when we'll do things together. Now, it's easy to overwork. When you're working from home, it's so easy to continue to work throughout the entire day. And then we forget to take that time to connect with our family. So I always say, make it a priority to have one meal where you can all sit down together around the same table and connect, because it's so much easier to just stay at work because work is just a few steps away. So just take that time for yourself, stand up, stretch, go for a walk, breathe, take a snack, and then connecting with your family as well.
Can someone get organized without any experience?
Absolutely. I am all about baby steps and quick wins. So the philosophy I teach is the 10-minute win. And I say, set a timer for 10 minutes because everyone has 10 minutes to spare. You know, you could find 10 minutes in your day, most likely. Pick one surface in your home, whether that's your desk, your nightstand, the kitchen counter, whatever that surface is, focus in on it, set that timer, and just try to clear that surface. And once that timer goes off, you're done. You're done for the day. Walk away, and more times than not, you will have completed that service and then some. And you can feel accomplished and good about what you've done for that day.
I love that. That's a great tip. How much time and effort does it take to stay organized? I know you talked about the 10-minute tip. What are some other tips when it comes to managing the organization? Maybe your kids come home after you do that 10-minute tip and then you're back to square one, it feels like. What are some tips there?
So life happens and things get undone. That is to be expected. So first of all, lower the bar a little bit, especially if you have kids, and realize that first of all, you should have systems in your home that the whole family can understand and it makes sense to everyone. So let's say the toy room, for example, we have kids, they play with their toys. As long as they can get their toys off the floor and into the baskets, we're happy. That's a win. They might not have alphabetized the toys and color coded them back to where you would like them, but at least they're off the ground. So kind of lowering the expectation, but then delegating responsibility, make it a family affair. So the kids know the zones of the home. Like if they go get the mail that day, they know they need to drop it on that particular surface every day. So mail doesn't get scattered throughout the house. Or if someone borrows your car, they know where exactly to drop the keys off when they're done. Same thing with shoes, socks, backpacks. So things are not scattered around the house. You have to get your whole family involved. So they know, okay, this is the drop zone for after school when you're unloading everything, and designate those areas in the home. And that will help make a much smoother functioning home.
So you do this, like we said, professionally, and you have challenges and boot camps and courses. Talk about sort of the what types of simple systems you introduce through these services.
Yeah, we do a closet boot camp where we refresh your closet. We take you through the process of taking your closet apart, refreshing it, and putting it back together in a way that makes you excited to get dressed in the morning. And then I have a organize your home in 7 days challenge. And that's where we give you a small, simple, quick win every day of the week for those 7 days. And so we do little things like that. And then I do a monthly web class on different things, such as going from organized to overwhelmed. This month we did kids and chores. So you'd get little pieces of education along the way.
I love that so much. And that's so helpful to have that mentor, you know, you along the way to help coach you through this process. What is your chaos to calm challenge all about?
It's all about the quick wins. We just break it down into 5 to 7 areas of the home that are usually the most traffic areas. And we help you find quick wins within those spaces. So it kind of catapults you forward and you know where to start. It gives you a jumping off point.
Talk about your podcast, Don't Get Lost in the Laundry, where you have over 70 episodes sharing tips and resources and aha moments with fellow busy moms, and maybe some of your favorite conversations so far.
Oh, this podcast, I have to tell you, it was a total blessing. It came at the weirdest time during the first shutdown back in, 2020? When the world shut down, I had always wanted to start a podcast. And I thought, well, why not now? So I started recording in my closet. I had an ironing board for my desk and I was using my phone as a microphone. And that's where I started my podcast. My first few episodes are not as great of quality as the later ones. And that's why I was in my closet on my phone. But it's turned into this really amazing platform for where I've met women all over the world and men, and they've offered us their expertise in ways that can help any busy mom, any family manage a household, and gives them tips, gives them tricks in all facets of life. Like I just interviewed a woman yesterday who introduced us to getting your kids ready for college and starting as soon as 8th grade. And building that resume for college. So introducing new things that you wouldn't have otherwise. We talked to another woman who showed us how to plant a garden with no backyard and produce your own, you know, fresh produce. So just, it's been a really cool resource to have.
That's so fun too, thinking about organization in different ways, because a lot of times we think about the tangible organization aspects, but like you say, it's also preparing your children for college, or preparing that garden with no outdoor space. So I think it's fun to look at it in a different lens of organizing your space. What puts a smile on your face when you look at the work that you've been able to accomplish?
What makes it so fulfilling and rewarding for me is to know that I've made somebody else's life easier. every time without fail, when I walk away from a project or a client, they say, it feels so much better. Every time, that's exactly what they say. And that is so rewarding because yes, it might look nice, but it makes them feel better. And that's the goal.
For those who are ready and are saying, BarbieJo, I've been looking for someone like you all of my life to help organize my life and get everything in a tidy space. How does working with you, talk about the piece of working with you?
Absolutely. So you could reach me on my website, which is barbiejo.com, and you can book a free consultation. We'll get on the phone, we'll chat, we'll do a video conference call. You could show me your space, even you can talk to me through your challenges. And then I can offer you three different ways to work with me. I have my in-home service, I have a virtual service, and then I have a one-on-one coaching service, which is also a component of a group coaching. So you get kind of a community of moms going through the same thing you are, as well as the one-on-one coaching.
Where can people go to learn more about you, download your free tidy checklist, and help simplify their self and space?
Come see me at barbiejo.com and book a consultation and we'll chat. I'd love to get to know you.
Thank you for watching the City Current Show, which is produced by City Current with funding provided by Lipscomb and Pitts Insurance, a Higginbotham company. To learn more about each of the guests, to share your stories of others leading by example, or to watch past episodes and more media focused on good news, visit our website at citycurrent.com or follow along on social media using the handle or hashtag #CityCurrent. We look forward to seeing you again soon, and thank you for all you do to power the good.